It's just rough. I love my wife, but it's just rough. Like, I got in trouble on my birthday because I wanted my own popcorn and Coke. That's just to give you an idea what I fight with about my wife. I'm in a movie theater on my birthday, and I go, oh, I have a large Coke and a, or a cherry Coke and a popcorn and whatever the lady would like here. And she's like, oh, we're not gonna split something? Oh, it's my birthday. I kind of wanted my own Coke and popcorn. Oh, well, isn't this a nice little surprise? It's not a surprise. Why is it a big deal? Like, I just want to have... Now, I look like a child on my birthday because I'm like, I want my own popcorn and Coke. What does that mean?
Well, I just think it says a lot about our relationship. You don't want to share your special day with me. I have an anniversary for that. This is for me, okay? Now, I'm angry.
Because it's not like, I'll show you something else. Like, see this stool right here? See that side of the stool? That's one side of my bed at home. Okay, see this mic stand right there? That's the other side of my bed, right? See where I am right here? This is what I get of that bed. This sideways coffin pose is all I have. I have to be a master of origami and fold my pillow into a crane and then tuck in tight like I'm Saddam Hussein hiding in a hole, right? I recently upgraded to a king-size bed, too, because I'm like, oh, that's more room for the king. No, it's more room for the queen. They trick you. That's what they do. A king bed should be an army cot you stick in the corner. That's for the king. And you know what else? I used to think, before I moved in with my wife, I used to think that the little ridge that they put around that top mattress, right? I was like, oh, that's just for decoration. No, it actually turns out that it's exactly the extra quarter inch that is needed to keep the man on the bed all night long. Didn't used to be a ridge, and men just fall off the bed. They're falling off the bed. What do you mean they're falling off the bed? And they got together, and the scientist was like, put a quarter inch ridge. It'll fix everything. Quarter inch, is that enough? I'm telling you, it's just enough. It's perfect. And they did it, and now we thank God for it every single night. Don't we, fellas? We go, thank you, Jesus, for this quarter-inch ridge. Keeping me on my bed like a gutter in a house. Thank you so much, Jesus, for the husband gutter. I appreciate it very much. And why am I stuck like this? Because my wife is very busy doing some kind of Tai Chi Pilates in her sleep. And she needs full range of motion because she is pretty. She does toe touches. She does toe, which really bothers me. Because if I try and get a little creative during naughty time and lift a leg or something, she's like, ow, ow, that hurts, stop it! But when she's asleep, she folds up like a damn transformer, just... It's like, roll out! There's no room for me. That's why when I go out on the road, first thing I do when I get in that hotel room, I get in that bed, I make a bed angel. I go, oh! I don't care if it's a king-size bed. I touch both sides. I do. I spread out. I don't care how uncomfortable I am. Like, it hurts so good. Woo! And I'll fall asleep just like that, right? When I wake up, where am I? Right back over here. This is where I wake up. It's not fair. And there's maybe some younger couples. Maybe you're newlyweds or you're engaged or living in sin. I don't care. I'm not here to judge, but... I'm just saying, a younger fella might be sitting here watching this going, I know what I'm going to do, Justin. I'll lay on my back. It's another option. Doesn't take up that much more space. No, you can't lay on your back. If you lay on your back, you expose your throat, rookie, okay? Yeah. The coffin pose works for a reason, because you're impervious to the throat area. All of your vital organs are protected right here. Seriously, you can take a shovel, and you're like, is that all you got? You better bring some more. And I know there's probably some nurse out there who's like, well, actually, you got a jugular there. That's kind of important. Well, actually, you got another one right over here, so you're okay, all right? So shut your face, okay? But if you only have one breathing apparatus, newbie, okay? And if you were on your back, you were open and susceptible to the rollover clothesline. Just, kia, right there. I don't know, where, you're asleep. Where are you going, ladies? Who rolls over with that much vigor? What do you... You roll over like you hate us. Like, it's ah! Or even worse, in the wintertime when they get cold and they like to throw that leg over to cuddle, right? Keep me warm. Knee to the groin. There we go. Who's sleeping now? Not daddy. Not daddy. But... You know, it's not all bad, though. A lot of ladies think men don't like to cuddle, and that's not true. Men love to cuddle, whether they know it or not. In fact, if you want to cuddle with your men tonight, here's how you do it, ladies, right here. Boom. Spooning position. Right? I found spooning will often lead to forking if you pay attention. And sometimes after a show, ladies, they will come up to me and they will say, Justin, sometimes I'm too tired to fork. Is there something for me? Yes, there is, ladies. You fork in the spooning position. I call it the spork, okay? Right? You spork it out. That's what you just breathe through it and you spork it out. That's what you, because the beauty of the spork for the ladies is that you can grab a pillow, you know, you get comfortable, you get beauty rest, your man gets a It's win-win is what it is for everyone. Everyone wins. And the reason that we love the spooning position so much is because your butts are in our laps. And that is hot. Oh, right? So soft. So sensuous. Oh. Right up until they fart on you, though. Right? Right? Then it takes a sudden turn for the worse, don't it? And always the girls always have the same move where it's like, it's not cute. I don't know who started this rumor that it's cute, because it's not, okay? You're not a geisha. Quit giggling, okay? Oh, where'd that come from? Your butt. Seriously, stop it. And here's another thing, a request for any other men that are suffering, that are victims, such as I am, myself, of this horrible atrocity. Ladies, do not Dutch oven your men. Do not Dutch oven. That's our thing. That's an us thing. Don't return the favor and Dutch oven your man, because that's emasculating. That's what my wife Dutch ovens me. There, I said it. She Dutch ovens me. And if you're too lady to understand what I'm talking about, do not fart and lift the covers over your man's head. Because that is emasculating for a man. My wife, I said it again, my wife Dutch ovens me. She does. She's like, yeah, get a whiff of that one. It's got an oaky start with a fruity finish, don't it? I love how in that scenario my wife is a trucker sommelier. Like, she's like, yeah, it's apricotty, ain't it? Like, she's gonna go breaker 1-9 and also knows the subtleties of a good cabernet. You know what I mean? But it's true. You know what happens to your balls if she Dutch ovens you? I'll tell you. They just roll away. That's what they do. They just roll out of the bed. Brrr, gone. You know, because they're like, we're for manly things. Nothing manly here. I'm out. You know? And that, here's the other thing. That's not even the gross part either. The gross part isn't being farted on or the Dutch ovening. The real disgusting part of this whole thing is that in the traditional spooning position, your hand is right here over the tummy, right? And you feel the abdomen flex. And you know what's coming. You know. But even worse, you know, there's nothing you can do about it. Nothing you can, I don't care how fast you are. You're not grabbing a cat to muffle that in time. And there isn't gonna be some slow motion sequence of you running out of the bed and then diving perfectly as her butthole explodes behind you. Crap only happens in the movies, never in real life, never, ever, ever, ever.